In this video, we're going to discuss how actions and triggers connect to one another in order to make experimental events occur in the proper manner, and how messages can be used to mark the occurrence of these experimental events in the eye tracking data file. The picture response example begins with a perfect illustration of the basics of experiment builder connections. The display screen action, which I've renamed to display camera setup instructions, presents some simple camera setup and calibration instructions to the display PC monitor. To see and edit its contents, simply double-click on any display screen action to bring up the display screen editor. From here, you can add images, videos, text, shapes, and interest areas to build up the display screen action's content. This particular display screen action uses a multi-line text resource to present the instructions. Display screen actions need to be followed by at least one trigger before connecting to other actions that change the contents of the display PC monitor. Otherwise, the contents of that display screen action will only be presented to the display PC monitor for one screen retrace. This particular display screen action connects to the subsequent camera setup action via a keyboard trigger and a timer trigger. Both of these triggers lead to the same camera setup action, so whichever one fires first will take the experimental flow onto that camera setup action. One of the most important aspects of action and trigger nodes in Experiment Builder is the message property. When an action occurs or a trigger fires, the contents of that message field are sent to the host PC and inserted into the eye tracking data file with a timestamp. These messages in the eye tracking data file are the things that tell us when the various experimental events occurred. For example, for display screen action, these messages are time locked to the start of the particular screen retrace associated with that display screen action and will be written to the data file within a millisecond of the associated retrace event. So, it is extremely important to make sure that you are filling out the message property of your action and trigger nodes. These messages can be used in data analysis to set what we call interest periods. Setting an interest period allows you to only consider particular components of experimental trials in your analysis. For example, when we analyze the data from this particular project, we will likely want only to focus on the period of the trial when the image was being presented, and exclude the period of the trial when the feedback was being presented. We can use the messages associated with the actions and triggers to set the interest period accordingly. We'll talk in more detail about interest periods in other videos. For now, it's just a good idea to remember the importance of the message field. Note, the label property of nodes can be changed, but a change in the label property only changes what it is called in the Experiment Builder user interface. The message property indicates what text will be sent to the eye tracking data file to mark the occurrence of this experimental event. This example was created by giving each node meaningful labels and then copying and pasting the label text into the message field. That way, it's really easy to associate messages in the data file with particular nodes in the Experiment Builder project.